So can you tell me a little bit about your involvement with the creative arts?
I certainly can. I've played in a few bands around like Teesside, Middlesbrough, Stockton. Mainly like three piece, four piece type things. And I do a bit of recording music. I've also made a few album covers for some local bands around the area, including, I don't know if you've heard of Chrome. They're like
Absolutely.
did their album cover for the last album and the album before, pretty sure. So I like to do that sort of thing. I like to make album covers.
And is that,
Like
is it, do you do that digitally?
a bit of both. So the recent one that we did was done by getting some marbling inks and then placing them on some water, and then getting some cloth sheets, putting them on top, and then scanning those in digitally, and then afterwards, like adding some other things to it. So it's a bit of like digital, a bit of like, I suppose if you'd call it analog, like type things. But yeah.
Brilliant. There's some great videos of people marbling online. I've always found it really calming to watch the process.
Definitely. I definitely prefer like liquid based, like mediums when I'm
Nice, and nice to mix it up as well. So have you always been involved with the arts as a kid? Did you come from a creative background?
I wouldn't say necessarily like a majorly artistic background, but like when I was a kid, I did like a lot of drawing. I used to draw like comics and that sort of thing. And for a while, I did go to like performing drama type thing, I remember. So that will have like, but I didn't find that that was for me. I don't enjoy being like in spotlight unless I'm doing music type things. I've noticed like if I'm playing on stage and I've got a guitar and like that's when I'm in my element, but if it's like something else, like sort of acting, I'm not really. I realized I don't really enjoy that.
Yeah, I've gone the other way. I always used to be in bands when I was a teenager, but I just realized that I hadn't. I tried initially drums and bass and then guitar and then vocals, and then that was definitely the point at which I realized that that wasn't my my forte. Quite annoying. Let me just
Oh,
pause
sorry.
a second.
I've been thinking myself, I need to get my eyes checked, to be honest.
Well, I broke
Especially.
my.
I was
Managed
just going to.
is just before lockdown, so ideal. So I might have to try and do a little bit of edit here to try and be professional. What kind of music do you play and what kind of themes do you cover? I ask because I remember you posted a song to the Arts Lab Teesside group, like covering environmental concerns.
Did post a range of things like when I posted those songs, I was obviously very aware of all of the things happening like in the world. I just needed somewhere to put that in a song, be like, look, I feel this way about these things, so that's what I did. And but I'd say when I started writing like very psychedelic experimental type music, and as I've went on, I've kind of ventured into more, I'd say, funk with elements of like hip hop, some always like the blues touch, obviously, because I play a lot of guitar, and that was like my early influences were the likes of like Muddy Waters, I guess, and like Hendrix and all the blues classics. But yeah, that's recently influences are more like dancey funk kind of elements of, like, don't want to say jazz because I don't consider myself good enough to be a jazz musician, but like lazy jazz, that sort of thing, if that makes sense.
Yeah, great. So do you have any, have you had any formal training in any of the things that you do creatively, or have you, I say self-taught, but taught through non-academic means?
So a bit of both, I'd say. Like, when I was young, I think in year one in primary school, I started doing like cornet lessons. So I ended up learning a little bit about music theory from a young age, and like how kind of sound travels. But I didn't look too much into it then. I just knew that like blow in the mouthpiece, it goes around some tubes and then comes out the big horn end on the other side. But and then I did do guitar lessons in secondary school for about 2 years, 3 years, and then from there, oh yeah, I did get taught a little bit of bass for like a year. Then from there, I just decided to kind of teach myself and go from there.
I guess we always, the question that I always enjoy asking, what do you think, for you personally and for society in general, why is the arts important? Why do you create? What does it give to you? Other than the idea of one day maybe releasing a record, or, you know, having a kind of final, like an album cover to design, what is it about the creation process? Is it itself? What does that give to you?
I think for me, it's actually all in the creation process. Like, for me, I just find the enjoyment in being able to create something that, like, allows someone to either look or listen or, like, feel and be able to communicate, like, an emotion or a feeling, or just communicate, like, this kind of nod, like, we're all here, like we're all, like that sort of moment that you get from art. I don't think, like, you can get it in life, obviously arts are within life, but like I feel like, I don't know, it's like this, just kind of a, yeah, like I don't know how to explain it, what I was thinking. I just think it's like beneficial, like emotively for people, like, because I know myself, there's loads of things that I couldn't just walk up to someone and like just start rambling on about these things. So if I can like find a way to incorporate a piece of art so that like they're looking or listening, like, and that's bringing enjoyment while also being able to transfer that knowledge, kind of. I don't know if that makes sense at all, but it's kind of why I like arts. Like,
yeah, it's really hard to verbalize, and I suppose that's why we have art, because you have these things that you want to put across that can only be done through music or visual arts or performance. And so how's lockdown been? Have you found that you've been able to carry on being creative? Has it affected your practice much?
I think I've definitely still been creative. Like, towards the start of it, I remember I just got in the mindset of like, I'm just going to get my head down and make art. And then as that kind of happened, like other things started happening around the world, and I was like kind of drawn away from my art for a little bit. But like then I was like, oh yeah, if like not doing this while this is happening is kind of making life bleak, then I may as well make art, because it's not gonna change anything that's happening, but it'll at least like boost my morale, if that makes sense. Like, it'll at least like steady the, like I don't know, like steady my mind while I'm process everything that's going on, kind of, I guess.
Yeah, keeps
so I think, like, yeah. My, yeah, so to answer the question properly, that's my art has been affected, but not all negatively. Like, there's been definitely some benefit, like positives that have come out of it. Like, but yeah, I don't like to look on everything with such like too much of a negative lens, even if it is like, you know, a pandemic. I think like still need to be able to find like some form of I guess like solidarity. I don't know if that's the word. That word came in my head, but I definitely don't know how to use that word right.
Yeah, well, perhaps that is a perfect word for it. You know, there's so, I mean, I think we're all so disconnected and no one really knows what's going on. But perhaps, you know, the fact that we're all still creating is something that does still bring us together. It's been lovely talking to you. I'm sorry we've never been able to meet in person.
Oh, that's all right.
The plans that were laid have been scuppered. I hope that we can pick up again soon. Who knows what's going to happen? Everything changes by day.
I reckon we'll, like, next year, hopefully. That's what I'm hoping. Like,
yeah. I mean, I think by next year, either we'll have accepted that this is an ongoing thing and we'll find ways to, you know, carry on and function despite it, or perhaps, you know, there might be a cure, you know, quick test, vaccines, who knows?
Either way, we'll be. The arts can't stop completely. Like, that's
no. That's no, absolutely. Well, I hope to see you out and about. It's been lovely talking to you.
It's been very nice talking to you as well.
Toodle-pip.
See you later.